you know why I'm here? It took them $80 million in three lying cases and seven rats that killed 100 people in the Witness Protection Program to finally frame me. You understand? That could never happen to me. We gotta defeat these people. Don't let them defeat us. And in this case, it's not them. It's us defeating us, defeating us, defeating us, defeating us.
Chile. Son muchas las preguntas por ahí.
¿Cuándo va para Cuba? Yo no sé. ¿Cuánta gente tiene duda? Yo no sé. Siempre sales con la tuya. Yo no sé. Pregunta a la web porque yo no sé. ¿Cuántos años hiciste preso? Yo no sé. ¿Cuántas cosas malas he hecho? Yo no sé. ¿Cuántas balas aguanta un pecho? Yo no sé. Pregunta a la web porque yo no sé.
We'll be right back. Yo, welcome to another edition of the Bodega. It is Friday the 13th. A lot of crazy shit happened today. Yankees for life. Mob Rats exposed. Cuban B, Red Dog, Mobland, Big Lou, Angel Gotti. What is going on? Marla, the best co-host. Man, Marla is the best co-host on the Angel Gotti show. She's so soft-spoken. Angel's angel. And then you got Marla. Like, that is the best combination right there, Angel and Marla. Marla is doing her thing. BK Skip, what is going on? Rap Trap City. Simping ain't easy. Simping ain't easy. What is up? Seymour, what is going on? We have Carlos from the No Fly Zone Weekends coming on. 556 Media, what is going on, buddy? It's been a crazy week. After the bodega last week, that Saturday, A Light, and I'll talk to this with Munez. A Light and his buddy was interviewing a transgender woman or whatever, a transgender. And during the interview, out of nowhere, starts ripping on my buddy JTP Dominic. It's so weird. So that happened. And what else? I gotta address the FBS thing. About last week, an informant doxed me on FBS thing. FBS showed a bunch of hurricane pictures. He addressed me by my first name, which is Damien, and I ignored it. I ignored it, and I let that shit go. But when he started fucking with Angel, I said, you know what? I took the gloves off, and some of y'all don't know. I know how to edit. I'm from the trash talking circle. This is what I do, trash talk. So what I did was went on FBS's, all his old videos, and all I did was simply use his words against him, just like how NB does. But I went from the beginning. I sat there, did my homework, watched all his videos. I'm telling you, I have about 2 months worth of material. Like, I already got a bunch of videos already. I don't know if I'm going to upload any more FBS videos, but I went apeshit this week uploading FBS videos. Then I went ahead and I uploaded, I think it was two of them, Aunt Lucy. I did the, first of all, RIP to Aunt Lucy. I did the first Aunt Lucy, and then I did the Aunt Lucy with the Maury wigs, and that's what did it. FBS commented, and he mentioned a couple of my family members, and he said, so I guess it's fair game now. And I'm like, shit. So I hit up Lee, and I say, hey, yo, Lee, what's wrong with your buddy there, man? You know, Lee was like, Tank Chase, you did talk about his aunt. And I said, but Lee, he's talking about his aunt on the internet. He goes, yeah, but the weirdos are gonna use that. And I said, man, you tell FBS that I'll take down the fucking Aunt Lucy videos. But stop being a weirdo. Stop looking me up, FBS. Stop looking me up. You know, I don't look you up. I'm pretty sure I can and find all types of weird shit about you. Stop doing that. That's weird, bro. Like, that's some real girl ass shit. Really girl ass shit, man. Like straight up. It's like almost informant stuff. You can't play fair. You can't play fair. So you wanted to start mentioning certain family members, and I want to protect a certain family member. So I said, you know what? No more Aunt Lucy videos, and I'm gonna chill out. I got 2 months worth of FBS videos. I'm gonna chill out. Because all this week, everyone was saying that I was doing a great job and whatever, and I was just uploading them, and I got more, but I'm gonna chill out, you know. Let's check the comment section. Shane Moore says Kane can't capitalize, complete. Now you're gonna make fun of me because I can't read it. The real thing is my vision. I can't see. Basically, I can't with the leftist. Marbrat's exposed. He is like a little piggy, definitely. Angela says, it wasn't Aunt Lucy. You made him look dumb. Yeah. It's crazy. You can't like, it was his words. It was his own words. I didn't add anything. I know NB uses his words and then does the little troll thing. I just used his words against him. Mobland, what's going on? Red Dog, Kane says, Unk, I'm sure FBI will make you put extra work in. Yeah. Angela, he's a punk. He's a punk angel. Yeah. James, Kane Chase, what's going on? But he is the one that put out his Aunt Lucy out there. Yeah, he put out his Aunt Lucy. You know what's funny? The last video I did about Aunt Lucy was actually a good video. I mean, he's talking about his Aunt Lucy and Martin Kruger or whatever, the Maury Wiggs guys. I made it a really good video. Like, he could have used that video saying that one of his family members was friends with a alleged mobster or associate or whatever. He could have used that video. That video was very well made. He could have used that or shared it and laughed about it. I mean, he's talking about his Aunt Lucy, so, you know. I'm going to drop the link. Pebbles, you are doing this because your hurricane videos got no views. All right. My hurricane videos gets a lot of views, Pebbles, on my old channel. It got a lot of views. And that's another thing. You know what? That's funny you say that, Pebbles. FPS, like, instead of being a weirdo, right, and looking up personal information, my Miami Hurricane videos of me acting like an idiot, ripping my shirt, Nebraska, Louisville, those are on the internet. You could use that, buddy. You could use that shit. But you gotta be a fucking lowlife and do fucking gay ass shit like that, man. Let me drop the link for my buddy Carlos. I see Mob Rats exposed in the house. Hey, Mob Rats, if you want to jump on, you're more than welcome. Uncle Zio, what's going on? All right, that's the link for Carlos. And if Mob Rats, you want to jump on here, buddy, you could jump on here. You're more than welcome to be on my show. Kid Rock, sometimes on the comments are jumping. What did Kid Rock say? Sometimes it's best to take out the trash. Yeah. What's going on? BK Skip, Carlos, what's up? Ron Gross, extortion. Hey Angel, I got MRE here. My buddy MRE.
Hi, what's up, brother?
What is going on? I wanted to show this, and I'll probably send it. Angel, if you have a P.O. box or something, I've had this about 5 years ago on eBay. I seen the coolest thing. I like sports cards and stuff, but I found the coolest John Gotti.
Oh, wow.
And it's a penny from 1987.
I remember you telling me that. Now, is the penny Gotti's head?
No, it's just a regular penny, and it's 1987. I don't know if you can read this.
Right, oh, here. Yeah, I can read it. Yep, into the Congo, 1987. Oh, that's a pretty cool collector's item.
If she wants, I'll send it to her and she'll give it to her grandkids. But this is pretty good. You know how much I got it for? Like maybe what, $4.99 on eBay?
Oh, wow.
So I thought it was something cool to grab. So Angel, if you would like that, I'd send that. Give it to your grandkids if you'd like it. But, so, MRE, what's going on? It's Friday the 13th. It's crazy. It's a fucking crazy week. What the fuck, bro?
Yeah,
they're Jason, doxing me, buddy. They're doxing me.
Yeah, you know what? That made me sick. And then people, I'm going to tell you right now, they mess with Kane and his family. It's I'll do the same to you. Don't hurt that guy and don't try to hurt his family. Number one, he only put a video up and it was just his words, like. It was his nerds. Now, I used the video of it and put my own words, but that's not Kane Shades. Don't take that out on him. Mm-hmm. Take it out on me. Don't take it out on this guy and his family. That's disgusting. Because nobody would mess with his family or do nothing like that. But I think he threw a lie out there recently. Somebody said that I doxed him or I'm doxing people. That's not the case. Listen, if I would do that shit, I'd do that on my name and put it right on live, put it that way. And I don't do that. I will not. It's something I don't do. Even though it was done to me, I'm not going to do that.
I've heard certain podcasters say that you're doxing. I've not once. Yes. Show me the evidence.
Prove it. Show me some receipts. Yeah, prove it. I dare them to. I don't dox people. It's something called integrity. It's something I won't do. And trust me, part of me would like to see you just pay for that, for what you're doing to people, trying to dox people. But I just can't do it. You know, they have families. They don't deserve that. And when it comes to the video, it's like, dude, it's his own word saying that. You're the one talking about your aunt like that. It's like, come on.
I don't know if you've seen the second one, right?
Yeah, but it was
really well done.
He could have said,
look, this is my aunt and her mob associate friend, and showed, because I had the real picture of Marty Cougar. It was well done. He could have used it.
Yeah, he should. Yeah, he actually should.
He could have said, hey, this is my aunt. I mean, he's talking about his aunt, and he said, look, this is my aunt. And it was I actually made a video for him. That was a really good video that I made, the second one.
Yeah, and you wouldn't have gave him a strike or nothing from using it.
I mean, I'm using his material, but I'm like his words, but I'm saying that it was a really well done video of his aunt's friend or whatever.
Yeah. Oh yeah, he definitely could use it, but he's like an emotional little broad, dude. He's like an emotional broad, a spiteful little mean girl, and he can't, like you said, he can't play fair. Just like a rat, dude.
Like look. I've been on YouTube for what, 10 years. There's fucking crazy videos that they could get. My cane shades, me smashing pumpkins.
Yeah, but they want to threaten your kids and your family.
Yeah, but they could use, like, come on. No kidding.
Just to go, like, yeah, get some video. I seen the video. It was hilarious with you chopping a pot, a pumpkin, or smashing a pumpkin or something. What was it, a watermelon, a pumpkin? I don't know.
It was a pumpkin. It was last Thanksgiving. So two Thanksgivings ago.
Hilarious,
Miami was playing North Carolina State on Thanksgiving, so I did a video where I'm smashing the pumpkin. But there's so many ridiculous videos.
You look like a madman.
Yes.
This guy, he looks like a freaking madman.
There's so many ridiculous videos of me floating around that they could use. They don't have to go do the family thing. They could, if they want to retaliate on me, find a crazy video with me.
What are they going to do? What are they going to do? Mess with your family, and then when it's done to them, and I wouldn't do it, but there's other people out there and trolls who will start and instigating people, and then when someone does it, you're going to complain. It's just insane.
It is crazy. Carlos, welcome to the bodega, buddy.
Change is my brother, MRE.
Hey, what's up, Carlos? I like the thing behind you. What is that? What are those things right there? Cologne?
Yeah, cologne.
Oh, wow. Pretty cool. Is any cool water? I used to like cool water back in the old days.
I gave it to my nephew, but I have another one that's similar to cool water, and it has a little bit more of a pineapple note in it, and that's the one I like.
Nice. Yeah, do you remember Jakar? Did you like that? I'm sorry to talk about this for one. I just said, ever hear that one from the old, like the 90s? Jakar is
still a classic. Like, I was up to 200 bottles, so I narrowed down my collection and I gave the other half to my nephew and I gave him a Jakar. But I keep an old school Paco Rabanne, which is similar to me.
Oh, nice. Yeah, he's got a whole collection back there. All right. Sorry, Kane.
No. I want to talk about cologne. I noticed that you collect, I've seen on Instagram, like you're always posting colognes and stuff. What is your favorite cologne?
Oh.
Kyle's is a cologne connoisseur.
Oh, yeah. He loves cologne. He got it, bro. What is that?
This is Pierre de Hermes. It's a vetiver, but it has a citrus note in it. This smells like $1 million. This is what you see a distinguished gentleman wearing with a suit coming off a private jet.
Nice.
Oh, wow. Yeah, my favorite is Nautica. I love Nautica.
Nautica. Yeah, I like Nautica too. Okay. I got a lot of like collectibles and stuff. One day I'll show all my collectibles. I have a collectible channel, like with all my little diorama stuff, but one day I'll show. One day I'll also put on my HEMA outfit with all my armor. I'll go live with that one day. Nautica right there. Yeah.
Yes, I love Nautica. Yeah.
This one here is vintage. They don't even make this one anymore.
Oh, wow.
The new one is watered down. This is the original.
Yeah, the Nautica was good. I even like the Curve was good. I got a few colognes, but obviously not even close to what Carlos has got.
It's crazy. Remember Michael Jordan cologne was pretty good, man, back in the day.
I never had it.
That, it smelled good. The Jordan cologne was pretty good, man.
He had a few. Like, my favorite one is the Jordan Legend. It was kind of like pancake syrupy. It's real. It's a gourmand one. I got it up there. That's my son's favorite.
Yeah, I see someone backstage. I don't know who this is.
Yeah, they're showing their face. Be careful so they don't come in and porn bomb you.
Oh, yeah. It's pretty.
All right, let me try this out real quick.
Yeah, my dog chomping a pot bones.
Yo, what's happening, boys? You know what this is. It's C.
Hey, my Irish brother. What's going on?
What's going on?
What's happening? Carlos, what's happening, brother?
Good to see you, brother.
You know what, lads? You didn't see your colognes, aren't you?
You like
see
the colognes?
You didn't see your colognes? Yeah. I'll tell you my favorite. Armani Acqua di Gio Profumo. That's one of my favorites. Oh, wow. Yeah, Blue de Chanel. Obviously, yeah, he's going to pull them down now.
This one here is my favorite. This is
Armani Profumo.
Profumo.
Yeah, man.
Oh, yeah. The women love this one. Yeah.
I'm a connoisseur with the aftershave as well, brother.
You know what's crazy? Speaking of colognes, I remember when this guy, FBS, figured out what was John Gotti's favorite cologne, the Gray Vinyl. I think it was Gray Flannel. Oh, he bought it. He bought it like in 2 days. He had the Gray Flannel.
Oh, here's the thing. All right. I get it. You can see what how much he liked and admired John Gotti, right? Mm-hmm. So just because you got in one little fight or you don't like that his daughter didn't throw somebody a bus, all your opinions and all your views change. And like that makes sense. Like, let's say if I loved Don Mattingly, right? Baseball player when I was a little kid. If I knew one of his family members and didn't like them, I would still love Don Mattingly because I love Don Mattingly for being Don Mattingly. You know what I mean? It just shows this very emotional, like a little girl.
He's a Marty, I think his obsession is quite chronic. It's quite sick, to be honest. The man's got a picture hanging up on his wall. Like, you know, I think he's disturbed in the head, to be honest. And all this Aunt Lucy.
This is funny. I'm trying to find out what Ray DeMeo used to wear as a cologne. I'm dying to buy it.
There are people that do collect. There are people that do collect like mafia memorabilia and stuff.
Oh, of course,
that doesn't make them weirdos, but he is. No. You know what I mean? He definitely is.
But the thing is, though, it's plain to see what he was doing. He was like getting into the Angel, and he's obviously doing. Oh, I'm speaking to the Angel, Gotti, this, that, the other. He's got a dad hanging up behind him, and it's just it's all come out now. And Kane, you were on it. You did say from a while back, didn't you, Kane? That you were onto it, and
I did a good job of ignoring. I did a good job of ignoring SBS for a long, long time.
Me too.
And then you know what? It was the Angel thing that got me. I said, you know what? I'm just gonna kill him with his words, man. So I just went on a rampage this week. And then when I got that message from him, I'm like, oh shit, here we go. Let me chill out before he, you know. But that's fucking crazy. Oh, we lost.
Now, what did he threaten to put up your children and your wife or something sick? Because he's
I don't want.
Gotcha. I
there was two people, but there was one person I was very, very concerned about. You know, because it's basically it was my ex-wife, and you know, I don't want to get into it, but I got family that watch this, you know, and I don't like. I don't want the father to get involved. Yeah, like you get it, like, you know. Like,
yeah, I get it.
Yeah, so.
Yeah, shame on him. Like, nobody messes with his family. You know, people that do that are just, like I said, lower than you can get, man. Mm-hmm. Lower as you can get. And like I said, he's mad that I did that video on his aunt and that you put it up. It's like, dude, it's your words. You said that.
Yeah.
You know? If anybody had it was you who disrespected her.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I'm not even like, God rest the lady's soul. I'm not gonna, you know, but shit, you want to do all these low things and you put a video up like that. You don't think people are going to make fun of you? Like, come on, you're doxing people, threatening people's kids to put kids up and family members up. Like, that, it's not.
It's crazy.
He's stupid.
It's crazy. Did anyone watch JTP's new episode?
Yes.
Carlos, what did you think about that?
It was great, but it just goes to show you how they continue to, you know, protect and bend backwards for these informants. And what a despicable informant that guy certainly is.
Hey, yeah, beat his kid. And I have he a was clip. His wife.
I have a clip that I'm going to play from. If you haven't checked it out, the JTP's newest episode, you need to. Someone dropped the link, but here's a clip. This is how disgusting Pascua is. Look how disgusting he is.
The defendant did impede the normal breathing or circulation of the blood that the defendant grabbed and squeezed and grabbed and squeezed his son's neck while pushing him down into a motor vehicle. So he's choking his son out, thereby causing this person to suffer physical injuries, including but not limited to substantial pain and bruising to the person's neck, in addition to causing the person to experience annoyance and alarm. So this poor kid was choked out by his dad, real tough guy move, you know, choked out by his father. And that's where the charges stemmed from. So it looks like they happened on April 12th. And then he was arrested, I believe, on April 20th or 21st, he appeared. So here you have the example of, again, a lying informant. Go listen to this guy on Vlad TV. Listen to this whole shtick he gives the audience about wanting to be with his family and raise his family and be a good dad. Nah, just a typical lying junkie back to his old ways. And it's very unfortunate that his son and his mother of his kid have to even deal with this. Again, it's like I was saying with these junkies, they impact everybody else. They're selfish people. Their problems become everybody's problems because they're little children. They're spoiled little children who need their drugs, and they don't care. They don't care who gets hurt. They don't care what family members they hurt. They don't care who they lie about. They just want their drugs, and they're just low lives.
It's crazy, huh?
His own son.
His own son, man.
Disgusting. I'm gonna stream that whole video one day. Maybe late tonight or tomorrow, who knows? But yeah, that's terrible. Imagine doing that to your son, threatening your wife. He's just an all-around bad guy. And that whole case started, that whole bullcrap case started rolling because of him. The grand jury, the whole nine, because of his lies and bullshit. The guy's a disgusting human being. And those men should be released from prison, all on the words, hearsay of guys like Rat Squaw and Ghost Panisi and Evangelista. These guys are crumbs and liars.
And he could have killed his son. He could have killed him.
God forbid. Rat Squaw's brother leaves comments. He's a very nice guy. His brother's a very nice person. And he leaves comments on my chat once in a blue moon. And he's like, yeah, it's sad. He's a nut and stuff. I feel bad for his family and his kids. My heart goes out to his kids.
And he'll be out. They'll give him a drug.
Of course. Even when they're in there, they live like kings. They're protected. You know, it's a shame. It's a real shame. And this is the people that the government use. These are their people. This is their G-men buddies. Their little wit sack scum.
He even has a rake.
Yeah. This is a bad dude.
No, and he did the story, and he said that it was mafia business. Yeah. So the rape, he's trying to dress it in mafia stuff, but rape. And then he has an intimidation of the same person he raped.
Yes, the woman.
Yeah, truly, truly despicable individual. And this is who they use, you know? Free Steve Freya, Maddie Madonna, Christopher Andonio, Terrence Caldwell.
Amen to that. That's for sure. Like, look at the character of this guy. Like, who could believe anything this guy says? Like, how could it blows my mind. How could a grand jury believe this guy? And they really didn't. It's just that. It's Italian Inquisition to grab Italian guys and call them mobsters and prosecute them. It advances your career as a prosecutor, as a judge, all that. So that's why, like, you can, there was some young kid a few years ago who got in trouble for like burning a car and got sent 10 years. I don't know the guy's name, but someone from New York, but He wasn't like a mob kid or nothing, but he was seen in pitches with people, and he got that name, I guess, and they threw the kid away for like 10 years for just for burning a car.
It's crazy.
And these guys, they give him special treatment. Look, you see, they were trying to debate on where they were going to house him because of his drug condition.
Yeah. And JTP brought up something very interesting in the beginning of the episode. There's a difference between someone who has substance problems and junkies.
Yes, huge difference.
It's funny. When I was younger, I got a funny story. When I was younger, probably like 26, 27, I stayed at a hotel for a few months, and there was a crazy old black man downstairs, right? Crazy guy. I was hanging out with him, and he was, you know, putting crack in his cigarette, smoking in front of me. And I'm like, yo, why are you smoking crack? And he goes, there's a difference. There's a crack smoker and there's a crack monster. And he goes, a crack monster. And he showed, you know those big water bottles? He had a thing of water bottles filled with quarters. There must have been like a few hundred dollars with the whatever. He goes, a crack monster would never have those quarters in there. So that,
Well, not only that, there's people who have substance problems that don't hurt people, don't rob their parents and crazy stuff. Mm. And then there's people where the disease takes them over and they do things totally out of character. And then there's people that are just like rat squaw that are just dirty junkies.
Yeah. All they want is their next drug.
And they don't care who they hurt, who they step over, because I'm sure there's drug users out there that wouldn't rob their mother for their drugs. You know, they would go work. There's people that do drugs and work and stuff, and hopefully they can get clean, but they're not hurting, you know, they're not robbing their family or abusing people.
He physically tried to strangle his son. Jesus.
That's crazy.
That's sick.
Junkies will steal from their family. Yep. They will sell their body. They'll do anything. They'll snitch. They'll do anything. The junkies will do anything. And like I said, like crack, like the black guy told me, crack monsters. They'll do anything, like the crack monsters and shit.
Well, they say one of the worst drugs is methamphetamine because there's like really no recovery rate for that.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, choking your son out. He threw him into a car too. Then threatened him after he beat him. He was even texting him with threats, texting his ex-wife with threats. The best thing that family can do, those kids, is just, you know, just get away from this man, because this man is just pure evil.
Coward informant.
Yeah, imagine beating up your
I feel bad for the boy. I feel bad for the son. I don't know how old the son is.
Oh, yeah.
I feel really bad, man. And
I think he's like 18.
And he's probably been abused all his life from that.
They were taken away from him and put in CPS, and I think then sent to family members. So it's just disgusting. And my heart goes out to them people.
Yeah,
imagine having a father like that who would like hurt you like that and derail.
I'm gonna remember that forever. That's the shame.
Of course. Yeah. He's like a man without a country.
But see, this is why you got to bring awareness. Like, if you watch that video, and I suggest people go watch Justice Tech's video, it goes to show you the lengths that the government does to help these lying informants. It's just crazy.
That's crazy. What's going on, Edwin? Thanks for tuning in.
Hey, Edwin, how you doing, buddy? God bless you.
Got Big Lou in the house.
Hey, Lou, Minnie
what's
up,
Moocher. Man? What's going on, Minnie the Moocher?
What's up, Mean Queen of Mean, Redzilla, Lloyd? Mm-hmm. This guy's an idiot. He's such he's like some UK mob groupie. He's always he's like down with all the rat and the nuts.
I am out full of hypocrites, and not one of you say a thing. I don't care if my own dad was talking BS. I would still call it BS. I'm going to put the Bald Fella Fragrant Connect collection to shame by. What the fuck is it? What was he talking about?
His name is Carlos Nunez, clown.
He's a weirdo. If you've noticed this, think of all the like the weird groupie simps who come fight for them. They're all mob names. Tony Cux Corallo, Mustache Pete, or they got an Al Capone avatar. Notice that.
That clown did a video about 2 months ago where he was in a tub with rubber duckies and everything, talking about my stuff, and then he pulled it down.
So don't you come up here
worried about my cologne collection from the
Ay, ay, ay. Oh, man. Let's see what Pebbles is talking about. What's going on, Pebbles? I was never in the streets, but yeah, I hate stool pigeons too because I used to watch mob movies and documentaries a lot. So I feel like a mobster myself. What?
No, okay. They're making fun of the Pebbles, though. The Pebbles guy who goes around with the docs and stuff. I think it might be a little pole smoke.
Oh, okay.
Which one is Pebbles up to? I think it's Pebbles up to 7 now? 8?
Probably. Who knows?
Oh, yeah. Multiple soccer counts.
It's crazy. In this genre, it's not going to, there's no off season. It's not like the sports community where you take a break. It just goes on, and it's going to end bad.
Well, because you got bums. You got bums that, can't survive without making videos,
And now it's more now in the open. At least I remember about 6 months ago when Doxing was done, they were doing it behind the scenes. Mm-hmm. Now it's out there in the front. Now they're telling you what we're doing.
Yeah, they're normalizing it. And smiling
about it. They full throttle rat right now.
Yeah. It's going to blow up in their face, though.
It's crazy. And it's like it can't happen to him, to them. Like what FBS threatened to do to me, I would never do to him. You know what I mean?
That's a difference between you and him.
Yeah, but someone else can, though. You know what I mean?
Well, yeah, there's people out there that
boo cry. He'll want to call the police. The guy in the car is gonna destroy me and burn my house down. Oh, come on, man.
That's the victim mentality. It runs rampant in this genre.
Yeah. I started just going after lying informants, and I try to stay away from content makers. If anyone's been watching me from the beginning, I never go at content makers. But man, when this fucking cocksucker went at fucking Angel, that's when I said, you know what? I'm gonna fucking load the fucking missiles on him, man. I'm just gonna drop the bombs on his ass, man.
Yeah, same thing. Like when he had the helmet on, they would talk about JTP saying they should all be in jail. I was like, look at these people, man. And then attacking Angel. I was like, why attack her?
That one show did it for me. That was the final straw.
And I don't know who this Fritzy guy is that FBS was talking about when he was talking about his Aunt Lucy.
Me neither.
But wait a minute. He said that Fritzy was a stand-up guy because he saved his Aunt Lucy's life, right?
I don't believe that. But
I'm just saying that, I mean, he's praising Fritzy, you know what I mean? So
that's when he loved
Federico Fritzy Giovanelli.
Yeah,
that's when he loved the mob. That's when he was loved. Now he wants to be a crime buster or something. Who knows, man? But I don't even believe that story. Why would it makes no sense? Like, think about it. Just some ladies having a bunch of affairs with these guys, and a big sit down happens over that. I mean, I don't believe. I think that they just told him that story, and he believed it. You know,
It's an interesting story, though. It was interesting. If he came up with it, it was interesting. Now, he should have used that second video I did, because that video it tells his story and a proper way. It was a good video. He could have used it. Fucking nuts, huh?
Sensitivity levels are off the charts now.
All the sensitivity, ain't it? Snowflakes. Mm. Little white snowflakes. That's what they all are.
So what's going on with you, MRE? What's going on with the Empire Strikes Back?
I did a video last night, and I'm going to do some more this week on certain characters and stuff, for sure. Mm.
Yes, please hit the like button.
And I'm going to do an Aleto video on him, like, running his mouth. I'm going to play JTP's video on Rat Squad and try to find some things on Rat Squad this week. I'm going to try to check in with Ghost Boy, see what Ghost Boy's up to, maybe get Ghost Boy shaking a little also. And then I got my sweet little bitch helmet that I'll deal with later this week. He's a sweet little special little bitch.
And A-Light, what do you think about A-Light?
That guy is just...
That video,
go at him hard, MRE, because that guy is just ridiculous.
A-Light Saturday dropped a video where he's interviewing a transgender, being very disrespectful to his guest.
Yeah, it was weird.
It was disrespectful to his guest.
Yeah, it was weird. Like they were like it was very sexual and bathroom, weird and
we were
creepy.
In school, we would take you in the bathroom.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. If you were in my school, we would have took you in the bathroom. It's like. what's going on with these people? They're out of them. I'll do a video on that. I don't want to say some certain things on here and unmonetize your video or nothing like that. Yeah. You know what I mean? But I'll take care of sweet little Johnny. Little got it with that one. Because they were in heaven. Did you see the glee in their eyes and faces? Him and Dowd, where they knew it was going to be a wonderful night. More than meets the eye.
It was insane. And then out of nowhere, he drops JTP's name out of nowhere. That was crazy, man. That was crazy.
He even asked that person the thing. He's like, "Wait, what do you think about it?" And the thing just looks up. He's like, "Giggle, giggle, giggle." I don't even know.
Oh man!
They hate that Dominic is a gentleman.
Yeah, 100%. JTP is a good dude, solid guy, gentleman, not a criminal. They try to like make him out to be like a mobster. Like these guys, they want him arrested. It's like arrested for what? Being a family man and. I don't get it.
I've always said it. If you disrespect Dominic, you're disrespecting yourself because Dominic is a stand-up guy. Straight up, you're disrespecting yourself.
He's a classic guy. He don't even berate people or abuse people or swear at them. He doesn't do what I do. I act like a wild nutcase on here, doing all crazy stuff, calling rats names, making funny voices. He don't do that. He's a gentleman.
And he's consistent. He's respectful and he's honest.
Yeah, you won't see Dom flipping every week or throwing his buddies under the bus, fighting with them, doing little girly things, exposing videos and throwing people under the bus at what they told him in confidence.
And he told me this person is straight. That's it for me. I don't need to question anymore. I ain't spending no money getting paperwork. I know this man knows his information. So he tells me he's straight. He got the right paperwork. I know it's good. That's good enough for me.
JTP's a paralegal. He knows the courts. He knows all that stuff. He's not stupid. He's other morons couldn't even tell you the three branches of government or who the first president was. Never mind anything else. They look at something automatically. Oh, he must be a rat. All right. Like, do your research, man. That's why I don't know how these people survived. I was never a street guy or nothing, but a lot of my family and friends were. And you don't call people rats without proof. You don't call someone a pedo without proof. I mean, stone cold proof that you can show some with paperwork or show them on the screen that it's an undeniable proof. Yeah, you can't just say, I think this person is.
And you know what's crazy? Another thing that content makers do, instead of like the whole Angel and FBS thing, they were friends, right? And then they just air everything out in public. Like, for instance, the Miami Heat,
the FBI did.
Yeah, but a lot of content makers do that. Like, oh, we're not friends anymore. Like MRE, you're a Boston Celtics fan. The Heat are gonna play. If my team beat you and we got into an argument, we're not gonna air out our personal.
Hell no.
What I mean? Like, it's crazy that they do that shit. You know, it's crazy. Text messages and
listen. I never broke confidence in my life, and not on internet neither with people I don't know. People that told me things are. I will never break confidence. I don't even tell my best friends it. Mm-hmm. Nothing. What I hear stays with me, and that's it. If somebody confides in me, and even if I don't like them no more, I don't talk to them. I would never still break their confidence.
Look at all the conversations I had with Angel. And it's fucking crazy, bro.
Lindsay Lohan. It's like Lindsay Lohan. Yeah, Paris Hilton. Yeah. Oh, my God. It's like a little girl. I know I disrespect the ladies out there, but it's like women, mean girls' tendencies. Like, it's weird.
Yeah, it is. Yeah,
He might be in latent homosexual, Murray. I mean, I'm just saying, it's weird, bro.
You know, listen, you never know what that. It's a very feminine aura, feminine, unmasculine thing to do. Such thin skin. It's like, wow. And there are good dudes who are raised by women. Don't get me wrong. But a lot of men that are raised by, hey, Mob Rats One, what's up, buddy?
Make sure. Thanks for the $4.99 super chat. Definitely, if someone could drop his link, he has a new channel on YouTube. Go ahead and support.
Yes, he does. I'll do it. But like I said, a lot of men who are raised by women and around women take a lot of the female traits from the women. You know, Like, we all need our mothers, obviously, but when there's no man, you need both. That's why it takes, you know, a mother and a father.
That's why I'm raising my little man. Because there's certain things, in all due respect, and shout out to the single women, you know, there's men that, that make it a lot harder because they don't want to be dads, but only a man can show a young man how to be a man.
And that's right.
That's why my boy's with me.
Yeah, amen to that. So many little, yeah, I believe that too. If, God forbid, the single parent thing had to happen, a little boy would probably be better. I would want to be raised by my dad, you know? Like, I love my mother to death. Don't get me wrong. You know what I mean? But in general, like, or anyway, I would have to say, yeah, of course, a little boy with a man and maybe a little girl with a woman, but there needs a mom and a dad.
Yeah.
Yeah. But this generation is soft as it is. It's not like the other. Like when we were kids, we would make up games, we would flip on mattresses, we would do whatever. Now everything is computers, everything is sports. There's so much change. There's so much sensitivity.
These kids never played manhunt or tackle football or nothing like that. You know, they're just like you said, they're on iPads in the house.
Here we got a comment from Big Lou. Let me blow it up. Just like a scorned ex-lover exposing private conversations full of straight feelings and all butthurt about it. He wanted somebody to throw MRE under and back him up. His plan didn't work. No. Ay, ay, ay.
Yeah, it's like a scorn. He's right. Lou's right. What's up, Lou? It's like a scorned ex-lover. It's like, dude, just leave it alone.
Definitely. I got 100. I got 117 in the house. Nice. Go ahead. Hit that like button right there.
There you go.
Sub to Mob Rats 1 there.
Yeah, I'm going to do a stream this week and shout out a lot of the of my buddies' channels on here, like Rat Trap City, Mob Rats 1, C, Bay 8, a lot of these guys' channels, even ones that are just starting out or been around. I'm going to shout out a lot of the channels this week. Assassinino, Dirati, Verbalmente. Yeah, all these channels.
Got to show support in the community.
Yep, yeah, your channel too, I'll shout out. Lou's channel. Like I said, I think once a month I'm going to do it and just share everybody's channels and stuff, do a whole stream and just drop links, you know?
Yeah. Ron Gross says, Kane Shades, if I ever told a story like that about my aunt and any family member, my father would kick my ass to this day. Wow.
Yeah, amen to that.
So,
Moses Heaps, what's up, brother? Make sure you go.
What's going on, Moses?
Yeah, Wee Man's been going a little crazy. I got to do a Durkle stream this week about Wee Man. I see he's losing it.
Oh, hey, okay, damn, I got it. A $5 super chat. Nobody should be calling anybody a rat or a chomo without paperwork. That's all bets are off. It's that simple. Just like a chump running his boat. It's crazy. Yeah, thanks for the $5, Big Lou.
Yeah, Mike Ward, legislative and executive and judicial, exactly.
Yeah, just reading the chat here. Yeah, hit that like button. I got 114 in the chat.
R.I.P. Jerry Jordan. Bill, sorry about your dad.
Coach 215 says, I learn positive things every time I watch JTB videos. The guy is an Amish country, teaches how to get over on people, huh?
Yanks for Life, MRE, I just lost another child friend last week. Sorry to hear that, man. Childhood friend, that's sad. Sorry to hear that.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Yeah, I went through that a few weeks
ago. Yeah, JTP, you learn things over there. And what his channel's about is teaching people about the justice system and how you can get help and all kinds of stuff like that. Exposing the justice system on the jury and on all these stoolies out there too. So
see, here's the thing. We're supposed to be going after, we push back. Well, me and Carlos, we're supposed to be going after lying informants. Right. But here's the thing. You got the content makers all fucking in the same house.
You know why? Because the informants knew to grab a few of these people who will do anything for money and fight their battles and keep the heat off them. That's exactly what it's about. Why do you think these morons, they wouldn't even hang with these people. They don't even like these people. They just use them.
Yeah, it's crazy.
It's a fact.
And I'm trying not to go after content makers. I don't do that. You know what I'm saying? It was just this FBS. It's almost like FBS is in the same class as these informants, bro. It's almost like he's acting like Eli. Like it's crazy.
Well, he is a cop caller and stuff like that over dumb stuff. And I'm sure he would. If he could put all of us in jail right now, do you think he wouldn't do that? Let's just be honest. Yeah, I wouldn't do that to him or anybody, but he doesn't have no parameters or no boundaries. He's like a little mad, like a little angry girl or a little fat baby who just wants to break the Nintendo because he can't win.
That's exactly what it is. And I'm telling you, all this week, man, I was going hard in the paint, man.
And that's why he made threats to his family members.
Yeah. You were doing good videos. You were using stuff that's out there. You know, it's not like you have to go dig for stuff and stuff. It's right there.
I'm telling you, I got more. I got like 2 months worth of it. Like, I'm gonna keep it in the vault, but I got more. If I wanted to, I could release more, but I'm gonna calm down now. But I got more, Emory. I got fucking
hit on that video. Super chat. Just popped in.
Yeah, let me see.
And thanks for supporting Kane. People send us super chats.
All right, two wheels, one family. Kane, if your videos were battle rapping, pay piggy, Mr. Potato Head, you destroyed him. Awesome job, Kane. That's what I'm saying. This is what I do. I'm from the trash talking circle. This is what I do. This is what I definitely. And then he got butthurt. Instead of maybe grabbing one of my old videos, I thought that's what he was gonna do. Grab one of my old videos, and I was prepared.
Too lazy.
That's why I had the axe. Like, I even helped him out there. You know what I mean? Like.
Too lazy, spiteful, vindictive, like an ex-lover.
That's like what I was just battling him. Broke up with. I was battling him like he was a trash, like we're trash talking, you know what I mean? But then he wants to fucking hit low, man.
Fucking passivity.
Informant. He's like an informant.
Oh, yeah, no, still following the open now.
That's crazy.
Like they're the type of people that they cry out in pain as they stab you in the back.
It started, and then the victim mentality kicked in. I've seen it today on one of the particular channels, screaming victim. Meanwhile, the guy took on himself. So it's ridiculous.
Yeah, it sure is.
Oh, look at this. He goes, I will make a prediction. FBI will start hiding his older videos. Guess what? I got them all. I got them all. Yay. I got, when I say I got 2 months worth of material, I got them all. So. Good luck with that. All right. Oh, man, my buddy.
No.
Notice my buddy. Kane. Here's another Kane Shades. Kane Shades. Hey. Whoa, what's going on? That's my buddy there. We started Kane Shades Radio. He knows. He does crazy videos, too. He knows.
Oh, that thing of you smashing the pumpkin was classic, dude. That was so funny.
Kane, Big Lou asked me a question today. He goes, wants to know what UNC stands for.
UNC. Oh, okay. So, originally... I brought my nephew into the sports community. My nephew started uploading videos, and then we shared a channel together, and he used to call me Unc. So everyone in the sports community would call me Unc, Kane Shades Unc. There's Kane Shades J, Kane Shades Unc, and Kane Shades Bo. So I got the Unc because of my nephew. So,
gotcha.
So gotcha. What really was why I started this whole hurricane FBS did something that I'm some kind of weirdo because I follow the hurricanes and whatever. I started doing this hurricane stuff to help out my nephew, to get my nephew out of trouble and take him to games and help him out. And it helped.
At least you don't have an Emerita tattoo on your arm. It's brass knuckles like a big tough guy.
I got a Kane Chase tattoo on my left leg. So
at least you're not calling the cops on people.
Hello, sports. And I say my team. You know, you can only say something like that if you don't watch sports. So
I'm very passionate about the Hurricanes. Very, and kept me. Believe it or not, man, it kept me out of trouble. When I started making videos, I was a year fresh out of jail, and it just was a hobby for me, and I just enjoyed it. I got my nephew, try to get my nephew going to games with him. My nephew started making it. You know, it got me out of trouble. That's basically what it was.
Yeah, I used to love that. I used to be a massive I stopped watching major league sports and stuff because of the commercialized, the trade. I don't know, just a lot of free agents, a lot of things like that, and the politics put in it. But I was like the biggest Yankee fan, you know, Giants fan, Celtics fan around. Yeah, tomorrow I should be doing a history video on Josie's channel about King Henry VIII.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. On King Henry VIII and his wives and his life, because a lot of misconceptions about Henry, but a lot of it is true. He was a brutal beast at the end. But when he was younger, he was not he was a very vibrant, athletic and actually good husband and stuff, believe it or not. As a young man.
I'm going to look forward to that.
Here, Grant. Grant, what's going on? I follow my soccer team all over the world, home and away. Every game, everywhere, anywhere. Yeah, I'm telling you, I'm a big fan too. I follow the Hurricanes everywhere.
Oh, Grant's like one of them. Listen, over in Glasgow, they're super fans, man. Yeah, they love football over there. Just like I got cousins in Italy, man. They love Lazio. Listen, they love their football, and he loves his Rangers. He loves his Rangers.
Yeah, he's serious about his team.
And Carlos,
oh yeah, listen, they're tough. Listen, those guys are pretty tough. Those football, sometimes they fight. They used to fight each other. I used to watch videos of those football soccer people fighting each other.
Hooligans, man. Don't play. They fight.
Yeah. A bunch of Irish dudes, English dudes getting bombed and like beating each other up. It's classic.
Yeah. Carlos, I got some cool Hurricane stuff. If you're a Hurricane fan, I got some cool Hurricane stuff I can send you, bro. I got I will hook you up, bro. I got
a bunch of baby.
Yeah. Yo, I've interviewed, like, man, I've interviewed a lot of kids, man. A lot of kids. Me and Bo. Bo was my friend Bo, he was the mastermind behind interviewing recruits. At first, I didn't like it. I'm like, what the hell are you going to interview 10th graders, 11th graders? I didn't get it. It was in 2015. I didn't understand, but Bo had the vision that these
the stars.
Yeah, they're going to be a star one day. And we started interviewing these kids and, you know, 17 of them that we interviewed. I mean, there's 17 kids in NFL that we've interviewed. And, man, so I really enjoyed that, man. I really enjoyed it.
My son is on a football kick now, and we just watched the documentary last week with Sean Taylor.
Mm. Yes. His dad, I went and I helped promote his he wrote a book about his son. Mm-hmm. And I went to where was it? Canesware and Davy, I believe. And we went and we helped promote his dad, Pete Taylor. We went and we helped promote Sean Taylor's book. So that's definitely cute. I got a lot of connections in the Hurricane. Yeah. Definitely. Well, MRE, yo, thanks for coming on, bro. We got 2 minutes left.
All right, I'm going to jump off. Kane, thanks for having me on. Carlos, hey, I love your cologne collection, man. God bless everybody in the chat, too.
Good to see you, brother.
Always. Later, brothers.
Definitely. You know what? I'll tell you what. If you want me and Carlos on a little bit longer, press one. We'll go. You want to ride out for 10 more minutes?
I'm good, yeah.
Yeah, let's ride out. Press one if you want us to ride out for 10 more minutes.
Shout out to the We Push Back movement.
Definitely.
Dominic Craig, Justice Tech Pros.
Yes. No rats or chats. We got a one. Ron Groves. Oh, we got a bunch of ones. Vito says, great show. Have a great night. God bless. Oh, we're going to stay on for a few more minutes. Maddie says, Yil used to chill with Muhammad Ali. So what got you into collecting this cologne collection? You just love cologne or?
It was funny. I've always liked the colognes, you know, growing up Spanish household, my uncles, you know, and I have family that worked for Aramis. So I knew all that I had all kind of Aramis, but then I got my first Paco Rabanne for home and that was it. And fragrances are memories. Cause small bottles and it'll take me back to a certain place. Like, wow.
Like Christmas time, holidays. And
I got a bottle up there of Quorum and my uncle, to wear Quorum. He used to love Quorum. So I still smell that bottle and takes me back there. It makes me remember, you know.
Mike Ward said, I really want to thank Kane Shades for protecting his family and MRE for showing everyone how a respectable man reacts to a thin-skinned, soft little girl, and Carlos Munoz.
That's right. Yes,
definitely. That's what's up. That's what's up.
Because there's men and there's males. That's the difference.
Yes. You got alphas and you got betas. What's Bill Jordan talking about? I had a Miami Hurricane jacket back when Two Live Crew was on top. You ever listen to Two Live Crew?
Oh, yeah. Uncle Luke.
Yeah, yeah. I love Poison Clan. I'm a big Poison Clan fan. You ever remember Poison Clan? Well, you're more New York.
No, I remember, but I remember Poison Clan. I used to wear all the bright suits and everything. I remember all the lights. Yeah.
JT Money and all that. What would you say? You're a hip hop head, right?
A little bit.
Of course. So what would you say would be your favorite like rapper out of New York?
I gotta go number one is Rakim to me.
Yeah.
Then I gotta go with KRS-One. If you're doing the top 10, Jada, Kiss.
Yeah.
Fuji Rap. Big Pun.
No Biggie. No Biggie.
No, I'm coming. Biggie and Pac.
Mm. Okay. Okay.
I love Biggie. Biggie was a storyteller. People don't. He doesn't get the recognition he deserves for his stories, his visuals. Like, he took you there, you know?
Definitely. What else? Any, like, rap groups that you liked? Like,
Public Enemy, NWA.
Definitely. Let's
see. Cypress Hill.
Rap Trap City says, can't believe you said Poison Clan. LOL. I've known JT for like 10 years. Oh yeah. I'm a huge Poison Clan fan. My favorite album from Poison Clan was Straight Zooism, man. That was my favorite. Big Poison Clan. See Poison Clan, it started with JT Money and he had Devonair on. That was a rapper, whatever. But once he put out that Shit What Your Mama Gave You, and then he had Madball Uzi, then his flow kind of changed a little bit. Trick Daddy Dollars is another one for Miami.
Oh yeah.
Rick Ross, I was never a big fan of. I never really got into
it. I always see him as a CEO.
I could never really get into him, get into the whole Rick Ross thing. So
now Rap Trap City's a good guy.
Yeah, definitely, man. Definitely. His channel's going to blow, too. If anyone could drop his link, go ahead and drop his link.
He got the best avatar.
Mm-hmm. Yes, definitely. And he got the little mask.
Listen, it's the best avatar. It's the best right there.
Yeah. Definitely. And Rap Trap City, whenever you want to come on, I mean, we're going to close the show in a few more minutes. Whenever you want to come on, brother, you could come on, man. Bring that little... He's in the dark with the mask. That shit is cool.
It rocks, dude. It rocks.
Yeah, it's cool as shit, man. That's what's up.
I wouldn't mind having one like that, but the Punisher. That'd be cool.
Yes, definitely. So tell me about the No Fly Zone Recons. What y'all boys?
We haven't done anything this week. We've just been freestyling, just having conversations online. We got a couple of stuff lined up, but we've just been, you know. Nelson's been working on the house. I've been busy over here. We had a little show yesterday. It wasn't long. It was just an hour.
Definitely. Whenever you boys want me on, I'll come on and show some love.
Most definitely. We got to do another subscriber of the week where we're just dedicated to one of the subscribers. Because I think that's awesome. Because they pump this mechanism. There's some good people out there.
Let me ask you something. You like 70s soul, like Curtis Mayfield, Al Green?
I grew up on oldies, especially from the 50s, 60s, and 70s. Oh yeah,
I love Curtis Mayfield. That album Superfly is one of my favorites, man. I could listen to song one all the way to the end on 9 or whatever. Yeah, man. I love Curtis Mayfield, man. Love Curtis Mayfield. Let's see what else is going on. Cuban B says sub to Rap Trap City. Props to DMC, DG, DG, J, and Master J. Definitely. Rap Trap City says, thank you all. Lots of love back, everyone. That's what's up. Pretty Monita says, Ken, I'm listening to Juicy right now. Definitely. Well, we pushed it 5 more minutes, buddy. I gotta get out of here, man. I'm gonna catch up with you, Carlos. I'm gonna hit you up.
Good having me on. It was good to see MRE on here.
Mm-hmm. Definitely, man. Tonight, man, we had about 117 in the house, man. We had a great show, bro. Great show.
That's awesome. That's what I'm talking about.
Anytime Nelson, Big Lou, anytime they want to hop on, they can hop on, man. Anytime.
Always. And you know you're always welcome at the No Fly Zone, you know.
Definitely.
This community strong. You have a good one, my brother.
Yo, I'm gonna hit you up later.
Yeah, definitely. Right. Everybody be easy in the chat.
All right, definitely. All right, so what else we got going on? Hustle Loyal Respect says FBS loves some boy bands. Ron Gross, Kane Shades Respects, thank you. Rap Trap City says Bill Jordan, MCA from the best, from the Beasties, Discovered LL. Yeah, the Beastie Boys. Angel Gotti says great show. Marla says great show. Hey, I'm out of here. Mickey, Minnie the Moocher, Ron Gross, Rap Trap City, Carol, Grant, Angel, everyone, thanks for showing love. Angel, I really appreciate the shout outs you give me on your show. David Hunt, I see you. I see you. Carlos Munoz, thanks for coming on. I'm gonna play a little bit of Don De Niro right now. Let's get into it. It's been a great show. Y'all have a blessed weekend. And I'm out of here.
Chile! Uh-huh. Son muchas las preguntas por ahí. Uh-huh. ¿Dónde vivo? Washington High.
What's up?
Union City.
Yeah.
Hialeah.
Que hola.
Oye, ¿cuándo va pa' Cuba? Yo no sé. Cuánta gente tiene duda, yo no sé. Siempre sales con la tuya, yo no sé. Pregunta a la juez porque yo no sé. ¿Cuántos años hiciste preso? Yo no sé. ¿Cuántas cosas malas hecho? Yo no sé. ¿Cuántas balas aguanta un pecho? Yo no sé. Pregunta a la juez porque yo no sé. Yo no sé lo que van a hacer. Que se meta conmigo se va a joder. El que respeta lo mío va a comer. Hay que entender que yo vine a resolver. Y pregúntale a mi hermano que ando bien. En Hialeah bien montado un Mercedes Benz. En el Bronx un camión de esos Chevrolet. Tomando, gozando, fumando puré. Cuando llego con mi rumba traigo el H. Hasta que llegue a mi tumba cubano seré. Dinero es que te la metió y se fue. Mírate, está atrasado y allá adelante. Tírate de que ya llegué, tirando bombas, explotando como un árabe. Móntate, mami chula, y prepárate, que la cosa está dura, chica, aguántate. Oye, ¿cuándo va pa' Cuba? Yo no sé. ¿Cuánta gente tiene duda? Yo no sé. Siempre sales con la tuya, yo no sé. Pregunta a la juez porque yo no sé. ¿Cuántos años hiciste preso? Yo no sé. ¿Cuántas cosas malas hecho? Yo no sé. ¿Cuántas balas aguanta un pecho? Yo no sé. Pregunta a la juez porque yo no sé. Ten cuidado y échate por un lado, que la cosa está buena y no se ha acabado. Y es verdad que tú da pena y caes pesado, con ese estilo medio raro, inventado. Y es mejor que te limpie, que te embarrado. Ya yo terminé y tú no has empezado. Capítulos, idiomas, dominado. Solo la cuenta de banco se me ha engordado. Mami, ven conmigo. Oye, ¿cuándo va pa' Cuba? Yo no sé. ¿Cuánta gente tiene duda? Yo no sé. Siempre sales con la tuya, yo no sé. Pregunta a la juez porque yo no sé. ¿Cuántos años hiciste preso? Yo no sé. ¿Cuántas cosas malas he hecho? Yo no sé. ¿Cuántas balas aguanta un pecho? Yo no sé. Pregunta a la juez porque yo no sé.